After Faraday's law, let's see Lenz's law. It is also a very important law. Lenz's Lenz's law. What does it states? It states that the direction of induced EMF in a conductor is such that it always opposes the cause. What is the meaning of this statement? It always opposes the cause. What is the cause of generation of induced EMF in a conductor? That is change in magnetic flux. So basically, whenever EMF is induced in the coil, its tendency by nature is to oppose the magnetic flux linked with it. I mean to say, when magnetic flux linked with the coil, you will increase, the tendency of induced EMF will be to decrease it. Or when you started decreasing magnetic flux linked with the coil, now the coil will behave as that you have to increase the magnetic flux linked with the coil. So tendency is always opposes the cause. Hindi mein ek kahawat hai, jis khali mein khao usi mein chhed karne wala, wo wala hai. Let's see experimental verification of this. Experimental verification. For verifying experimentally, you have to have number one bar magnet, a coil, sensitive galvanometer, two-way key, battery or cell and connecting wires. You have to conclude by yourself. I am making an arrangement for this apparatus. This is a coil which is connected through a sensitive galvanometer. The coil is here, connected with two-way key. As we know, in two-way key there are two gaps, three terminals. So I am marking the terminals 1, 2, 3. Connect your battery here, 1 and 3. Right. Now see the experiment. First connect 2 and 3. Plug in 2 and 3. When you plug in 2 and 3, the battery will be out of the circuit. So battery will not have any role. The current cannot flow in this circuit because battery is not in the circuit. Now move north pole of bar magnet rapidly towards the coil. When you move bar, north pole of the bar magnet rapidly towards the coil, the magnetic flux linked with the coil changes. It induces an EMF across it. The galvanometer shows deflection. So in the first observation, what you have to record? Record deflection in galvanometer. Say for example, the galvanometer needle deflects right to its zero, and as we know, zero is at the center of the center in the galvanometer. So I repeat it again. First step, what is first observation? Move north pole of a bar magnet rapidly towards the coil. This induces an EMF in the coil because magnetic flux linked with the coil changes, and galvanometer shows deflection. We have assumed in our observation galvanometer needle deflects right to the zero. Now remove magnet in the second observation. Remove magnet. Disconnect 2 and 3. Remove this magnet. Disconnect 2 and 3 and connect 1 and 2. When you connect 1 and 2, then battery is in the circuit. Now current will flow from positive terminal through this coil and coming back to the negative terminal. The direction of current in the upper face of the coil is anti-clockwise. So direction in the upper face of the coil is anti-clockwise. And as we know from magnetic effect of current, when direction of current flowing in the coil is anti-clockwise, what type of pole does it work? North pole. Record the deflection of galvanometer needle. You will see the galvanometer needle is deflected again right to the zero. That's how he explained that my statement is correct. Now you might be surprising how he said that his statement is correct. You can also judge it very well. When you moved north pole of a bar magnet towards the coil, deflection in galvanometer is right towards the zero. When you made a flow of current through the coil and direction of current was anti-clockwise, at that time galvanometer needle was deflecting right to the zero. It means in the first observation, when north pole was moved, tabhi induced current ki direction anti-clockwise hogi. Aur agar anti-clockwise thi, to kis tarah ka pole ban raha hoga? North. किस तरह का पोल आप मूव कर रहे थे? नॉर्थ. सो व्हेन यू आर मूविंग नॉर्थ पोल रैपिडली टुवर्ड्स द कॉइल, एन आइडेंटिकल नॉर्थ पोल इज फॉर्म्ड. एंड एज वी नो देयर इज अ रिपल्शन बिटवीन टू आइडेंटिकल पोल्स ऑफ द मैग्नेट. सो दैट्स हाउ ही सेड इट अपोजेस द कॉज. एंड इन फैक्ट इन Faraday's law, the value of K I told you is minus 1. Remember, this minus K equals to 1 is because of the Lenz's law. Because he said minus means direction is opposite. Induces, it always opposes the cause. So that's how he has proved that direction of induced EMF is such that it always opposes the cause. Now what generally it means? You see, when you are moving north pole of a magnet rapidly towards the coil, north pole will be formed. When you are moving north pole away from the coil, north pole is taken rapidly away from the coil, then what kind of pole should form? South pole will form. right? Why? Because when you are moving north pole away from the coil, अब मैग्नेटिक फ्लक्स लिंक विद द कॉइल डिक्रीज कर रहा है. जब मैग्नेटिक फ्लक्स लिंक विद द कॉइल डिक्रीज करेगा, देन टेंडेंसी ऑफ इंड्यूस्ड ईएमएफ इज व्हाट विल बी व्हाट टू इंक्रीज द मैग्नेटिक फ्लक्स लिंक विद इट. तो ये साउथ पोल बना देगी. साउथ पोल क्या करेगा? इट अट्रैक्ट्स नॉर्थ पोल टूवर्ड्स इटसेल्फ. सो द टेंडेंसी ऑफ द कॉइल विल बी टू कम बैक टू ब्रिंग नॉर्थ पोल बैक and increase the magnetic flux linked with the coil. That's what is very interesting. But in overall issue of electromagnetic induction, Faraday thought that he has obtained current in the coil because of the conversion of magnetic energy into electrical energy. But after moving bar magnet thousands of the times towards the coil and away from the coil, when he measured strength of the bar magnet, it remained same. So there is no loss. Then a question arises: is the electromagnetic induction phenomenon violating law of conservation of energy? And of course, you can be sure that law of conservation of energy can never be violated. If it is violated, then we all are in trouble as a physics person, right? Because law of conservation of mass is already finished. So the next article is related with this, that is Lange's law and conservation of energy. Now, question arises, how Lange's law is at par with law of conservation of energy? So he made everything clear as in his statement, it always opposes the cause. So what is happening practically? When you have a coil and moving north pole of a bar magnet rapidly towards the coil, we have seen what kind of pole is formed? North. Or while you are moving south pole towards the coil, what kind of pole is formed? South. So when you are bringing south pole of a bar magnet or north pole of a bar magnet towards the coil, as the magnet coming closer and closer to the coil, the strength of the north pole or south pole formed on the coil increases, and then obviously it repels the coming north pole towards it with a stronger force. So practically, when you have decided to move it towards the coil, so you have to work against a force of repulsion. और ये force of repulsion हर बार बढ़ता जा रहा है, because as closer as you are reaching, force of repulsion is increasing. It means you have to increase the amount of work against the approaching north or south pole. तो actually जो आप मैकेनिकल वर्क कर रहे हो अगेंस्ट द पर्टिकुलर पोल ऑफ द मैग्नेट विच इज मूविंग टूवर्ड्स द कॉइल, दिस वर्क डन गेट्स कन्वर्टेड इनटू इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी. सो व्हाट हैज बीन कंक्लूडेड फाइनली अकॉर्डिंग टू द लेंजेस एक्सपेरिमेंट एंड लेंजेस एक्सप्लेनेशन, दैट phenomenon of electromagnetic induction जिसके अंदर current और EMF induced होता है, ये वास्तव में magnetic energy into electrical energy का conversion नहीं है. तो magnetic energy electrical energy में convert नहीं हो रही है. What is not happening? magnetic energy is not getting converted into electrical energy. Then what is actually happening? It is a mechanical work in overcoming force of repulsion is actually getting converted into electrical energy. So electromagnetic induction phenomenon is an example of conversion of mechanical energy into electrical energy. That's what is the conclusion of Lenz's law. And yes, Lenz's law is very much in accordance to law of conservation of energy. Now we have talked about EMF, induced EMF. Suppose induced EMF is induced across the ends of the coil. Even the two ends of the coil are open, EMF will be appear across these two points. But if you want to see the current, then this coil must be forming a circuit, must be closed, right? So to find current, you can say induced EMF over R. What is R? Resistance of the coil. So you can calculate induced EMF as well as induced current magnitude flowing through the coil. Now question arises, how do I find the direction of induced current in the circuit? For this you have to use Fleming's right hand rule. For finding direction, of induced current, you have to use Fleming's right hand rule. What is Fleming's right hand rule? It is very much parallel to Fleming's left hand rule. If you remember, I told you left hand. In the left hand, keep your thumb, forefinger and central finger at right angles to each other. So now you keep thumb, forefinger and central finger at right angles to each other. And again read it as father, mother, child. Father stands for force, or here you can say motion. Thereby sending force, here you can say direction of motion of conductor. Mother is standing, mother corresponds to magnetic field. And R, child currents, corresponds to current. So I will tell you again, direction of motion of conductor is thumb. Direction of magnetic field is given by the forefinger. The direction of, you can see now, direction of this finger, direction of thumb is motion, direction of forefinger is magnetic field, direction of this is current, in the induced current in the circuit, right? But remember, you have to use right hand and you have to keep all these three at right angles to each other.